It's almost like everything we've been saying about the MCU for the past couple years has actually been true. Fans are walking away. People are less interested. Massive box office disappointments, streaming failures time after time. And now word is coming down that Marvel is planning on a reboot. The only question is, will it get here in time? I think the jury's still out on that. I'm not sure if there will be many fans left by the time they're ready to reboot. But everyone has recognized that Marvel has hit a low, both with their theatrical releases and with their streaming nonsense that they're putting out, and it's not sustainable. And now, with a new book that was just released, with like over 100 different interviews with producers, writers, directors, actors, everybody involved in the building of the MCU, some of the plans that they have going forward have been revealed. Avengers 6 will soft reboot the MCU and bring back retired characters. Kevin Feige, quote, backs rumors. And this is pretty much some of the big things that are coming out of this. So Reign of Marvel Studios, this is the book that was released, has basically confirmed Secret Wars will launch a soft reboot of the MCU. Past characters will return. T'Challa, Tony, Steve Rogers, the Sony Spider-Man verse, I think that's basically what this means, will be part of MCU canon, and it'll get a fresh coat of paint. Essentially, this will give them an opportunity to take these characters that aren't working, get rid of them, bring back characters that they know people want, all this shit. Also, some other stuff was revealed in it. Like, originally, they had planned on Spider-Man, Black Panther, and Captain Marvel to be, like, the faces of the MCU going forward, until, obviously, the Sony deal, there was a hiccup. We know the actor who played T'Challa, Chadwick Boseman, passed away, so that didn't work, and people just hated the character of Captain Marvel. So pretty interesting shit. But the idea that now we're getting kind of confirmation of some of the reports and potential rumors that have been out there that Secret Wars, the movie, might do a soft reboot in some way, that certainly all seems to pan out. The problem, Jay, is that that's not planned until 2027. Oh, if they wait that long, there might not be any MCU fans left who are going to even enjoy a reboot.
Totally agree. They need to just stop everything and just let people breathe a little bit. They're putting out way too much content, and it's confusing content at that. I think the multiverse stuff has really messed them up big time, because people that don't understand what that is, that love the story from, and I go back from like Iron Man to Endgame, they were telling a story, whether you liked all the movies or not. Now you have the multiverse where people are just like, if they don't understand what it is, they're just confused and they just don't care. I did see a report too that they really thought that Ant-Man and the Wasp, Quantumania, was going to be this massive start. Ah, there it is. I didn't even know you're going to pull this up. It says, we put out a banger. Marvel was shocked by Ant-Man 3's negative reviews. Dude, that movie was terrible. And it's coming from someone, I actually enjoyed Ant-Man 1 and 2. They just screwed this character up. This movie was, hey, we need an army. Hey, we got ants over here. All right, cool. We'll use
communist
them.
Ants.
We need to figure this out. I'll just grow large.
Yeah, and like, also just ignore all of the actual like scientific backing we had about why we need to have this helmet on at this point and that point, because, hey, you're changing, but the air molecules aren't, like, all this shit, right? Some interesting things that they just completely have ignored. But the fact that they did think it, they have lost complete contact with what the normal viewing audience wants and cares about. So when you look at things like Ant-Man, when you look at things like Secret Invasion, they thought those, both of those things were going to be awesome. They thought people were going to love these shows, love these movies, and people rejected them wholeheartedly, not just in terms of the critics or whatever, but everybody. And the fact that also in Ant-Man, the two times we've seen Kang, the guy that you're supposed to be setting up to be the next Thanos, the two times we've seen him, one, he's a clown who gets killed by female Loki in Loki season one. And then the second time, he gets defeated by Ant-Man. That's it. Not like it took all the Avengers to bring him down, right? Just defeated by Ant-Man in the quantum realm. Yet you're telling us that people are supposed to fear this guy, that he's so, like, you should really be scared of him? The fuck on. It might take 200 of them. It might take 2,000 Kangs to bring everybody else down. I don't know. No, but yeah, what a nightmare they've found themselves in.